startups like Tesla and Rivian were the first to bring a three-row electric SUV to market. But now, this OG automaker is entering the game with the 2024 Kia EV9. Sure, the Tesla Model X and Rivian R1S beat it to the punch, but is the EV9 actually the best of the three-row EV bunch? Let's find out. At the front of the EV9, you've got this very broad, boxy shape with a flat face that's made to look even flatter because it doesn't have any grill openings. You know, this is an EV, so it doesn't need a ton of airflow into the engine because there is no engine. There are 5 different trim levels of the EV9 to choose from, and this one is at the top of the food chain. It's called the GT line. Now with that, you get gloss black exterior accents around here just to make some of these signature elements pop. Speaking of signature elements, if you look closely here, you can see little perforations. Those actually have LED lights behind them, and when you turn the car on, they can create different welcome animations, which is a first for Kia, and definitely adds some personality to this otherwise pretty bland face. Now, every EV9 comes with LED headlights, which have a really cool packaging to them, but this one, the GT line, has upgraded LED headlights to give it an even more dynamic look. Compared to the Tesla and the Rivian, the Kia has some interesting dimensions. First of all, it's the shortest of the three from nose to tail, but the wheelbase, or the length from the front wheel to the rear wheel, is the longest of the three. Now, typically, that equates to a smoother ride on the road, so we'll see how that feels when we get behind the wheel. Total ground clearance for the EV9 is 7.8 inches, which is right in between the Tesla on the low end and the Rivian on the high end. From this angle, you get a good look at these giant 21-inch wheels on this model, which look even bigger in person, maybe because it's got all this filled-in space, but they definitely have a presence to them. You can also see these flush door handles that pop out when you're ready to get in, and the fact that the doors are absolutely massive. They go all the way down here. I don't know if I've seen a door that big before, or at least not in a while. You can also get a good look at just the really interesting design and styling of this car and that gorgeous bright blue contrasted with the black accents. At the rear of the EV9, you can really see this kind of retro 80s themed styling language going on with just straighter lines everywhere. It kind of looks like if you tried to draw a Kia Telluride in Microsoft Paint. There's a neat kind of brushed aluminum look to the Kia logo here and the EV9 one down here. And you've also got the badge for the GT line to let everyone know you got the biggest and baddest model on the block. Up top, you've got big raised up roof rails for some added functionality and this pretty massive rear spoiler coming all the way off the roof. Now, one big thing to note is that the max towing capacity for the EV9 is 5,000 pounds. That's not world beating, but it is important because that's the same max towing capacity as most versions of the most recent Telluride. So if you like the Telluride and you're thinking about maybe going EV, the fact that the EV9 has the same tow rating is actually a pretty big deal. Under the hood, you get no engine because of course the EV9 is fully electric. Now there are 2 different battery versions that you can choose from, but the smaller battery is only on the base version. So only get that one if you're trying to stay under a budget. Once you move up to the larger battery, there's a trim designed for long range with an EPA estimated 304 miles of range on a full charge. There's also a dual motor version with more power, and then there's this, the dual motor version juiced all the way up to 379 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. Now, even with all this power, this GT line model is EPA rated at 270 miles of range, but we've seen evidence that it may be capable of far more than that. Just from driving around town, but also when we got in the car this morning, it showed an estimated range of more than 330 miles. So results may vary. At the back of the EV9, you can find its charge port. Now, the interesting thing about the way the EV9 is set up is that it runs on an 800 volt electric architecture, like a lot of Hyundais and Kias do. Now that increases efficiency, it reduces weight, and it helps enhance your performance or your total range. One last thing on charging, Kia offers new EV9 owners up to 1,000 kilowatt hours of charging at Electrify America stations across the country. Now that's a generous offer, and it may be an attempt to offset the fact that the EV9 is not going to qualify for the full $7,500 tax credit like the Tesla Model X and Rivian R1S do. Still a nice offer. The starting price for a 2024 EV9 is just over $56,000. Now, there are several different trim levels that you can move up to that will increase in price. And this one, the GT line at the top of the line, is a hair over $75,000. That's a lot of money. But keep in mind, it's less than the starting price of the Tesla Model X or the Rivian R1S. Now, let's hop inside and see if the cabin can sweeten the deal. Inside the EV9, the vibe of the exterior design is carried forward into the cabin, and I would describe it as kind of retro chic, but not in like a cold way. A lot of modern cars feel like they want to just sanitize everything with their design, but there's some warmth to this cabin because of the materials that they use. And what I like about it is that there's a lot of mixture. They're playing with different things. So up here, there's a fabric on this panel, and then a soft touch on the top, and then this cool like diamond pattern down here. Some aluminum trim all the way around. Some of the buttons have this like matte feel to them, and others have this almost glossy wet cement type look. So the mixture of the different things that they're using in here ties together really nicely. Now let's talk about what comes standard. First, there's this 3-zone automatic climate control. There's also front seats that are heated and ventilated. And since this is the King of the Hill GT line model, these are upgraded seats. So they've got extra cushioning, extra bolstering, and really digging this two-tone look as well, plus this kind of bouncy netting up on the headrest. The interior dimensions of the EV9 are pretty much similar to the Tesla and Rivian versions, but the EV9 is supposed to have 2 inches less of headroom in the front compared to those models. But I'm 6 feet tall, and as you can see, I've got plenty. When it comes to electronics, the EV9 gets dual 12.3-inch screens. These both come standard. Also standard, in the middle, in between them, is a 5-inch display just for the climate controls. So you do have physical buttons down here, but they're really basic functionality, and then there's more options up here. One helpful thing is that if you press this plus sign icon up here, it automatically brings the climate display onto the main screen. So this comes standard with navigation, Apple CarPlay, and Android Auto, and I really like the look and feel of it. It responds really quickly to the touch, and it just gives you a very responsive, almost smartphone-like experience. There are also not physical buttons, but icons that you can press down here to immediately jump to certain menus. And a bunch of these pages, which is a personal favorite of mine, will show you the way that your energy is being used, like your current battery status, the different components that are taking up your electricity use. There's just a lot of cool information in here that I really like in an EV, so you can see exactly where all this juice is going. Now, the driver display in front of me here has pretty basic information, things like your range, your trip monitors, your tire pressure, but it looks really nice. This is also where you get a view of your lane change camera if you signal to go to the left or to the right. Finally, every EV9 comes standard with a wireless charging station, and this one also has a digital rearview mirror, surround views of the entire exterior, and a head-up display. The second row is an afterthought in a lot of cars, but not in the EV9. You get the same nice plush upgraded seats back here with the two-tone, and those materials that were very cool in the front are carried over back here. So more of that fabric, more of that wet cement gray up here. Just a really nice combination that adds more warmth to the back seat as well. This one's also got sunshades, and there's a cool fabric on the back of the front seats, and you can poke your dad through that netting in the headrest. Great feature. Controls for the climate system are right up here, and you've got these nice, really cool looking vents up in the ceiling as well. If you need further temperature control, these seats are heated and cooled, and they're controlled right here. There's also charge ports up here on this seat and on this one over here. And I really like this pull-out tray / storage compartment. The EV9 comes standard with a bench seat back here to seat 3 passengers or 7 in total. But this model has the captain's chairs, so you can easily access the third row just by squeezing through there. But what if you need to access the back from the door? Let's check that out. So if you have the power seats, it's really easy because there's a button up on the shoulder and down here that do the same thing. With just one press, it'll automatically start moving forward and folding down at the same time. Now, you could also just pull these bright red cords back here and fold it all the way down like that. Either way, it creates a lot of space to easily get back into the third row. Now, once you're back here, there is space. I've got enough space to sit. It's just my knees are resting up against the back of the seat. And this seat will actually go further back, so you can really scrunch the room back here if you want to. Once you're back here, what do you get? Well, on the GT line, you get more of these really soft cushioning synthetic leather seats. You also get charge ports over here and over here, and more vents up here. And the cup holders are finished in that wet cement gloss gray. So again, really nice accommodations. Way back here, the EV9 has 20.2 cubic feet of space behind the third row. That's slightly more than the R1S and probably quite a bit more than the three-row Model X. Tesla's a little bit vague on their capacity numbers. What do you get back here? This is the charge cord case. If you do need more space, you can fold down the third row by pulling these straps and pushing them down. And if you want to fold down the second row too, there are power buttons on this model right over there. One more thing to show you back here, and that is this socket, which is Hyundai and Kia's V2L system, or vehicle to load. Now that draws power from the vehicle's actual battery, and you can use it to power really any electronics, from household electronics to power tools, maybe even an air conditioner, depending on the size of it. So this is a really cool innovation that some EVs are coming out with these days. Definitely handy to have around a campsite or something like that. Behind the wheel of the Kia EV9 now, and there is a lot to digest here. So first of all, it does feel like a big vehicle. The hood, you've got this big, broad, wide hood that you're looking over, and you're just aware of the boxy design of this thing. But it doesn't feel trucky at all. In fact, it feels pretty futuristic. We're using the steering wheel, which is kind of squared off a little bit. There's a droning sound when you use the accelerator, kind of like a robotic hum every time you accelerate. And the power itself is really smooth, crisp, seamless. Now, obviously it's an EV and that's one of the hallmarks of an EV, but even for a fully electric vehicle, this is getting up to speed really quick. Just as soon as you're touching that accelerator pedal, you're getting a response. I definitely think there are some aspects of luxury or near luxury here. I really like the quiet ride. It feels like you're almost vacuum sealed inside here. And as far as the ride quality goes, I think the long wheelbase here is helping the EV9 quite a bit. You're still feeling bumps and cracks in the road, but it's all handled smoothly and then you move on. And when you do get to smooth roads, the ride is genuinely cloud-like. So down here on the steering wheel, you've got two different buttons that do some interesting things. There's four-wheel drive lock if you're gonna go off-road in your EV9 and really get rugged and dirty. And then there's drive modes, which will toggle through all your different options. So we've been in normal this whole time. There's also sport. There's my drive, which is kind of an individualized group of settings. There's snow, and then there's eco for when you're really trying to squeeze out that total range. So let's drop down into sport and see how that changes things up here. So all this power is at my disposal right now. You can definitely tell the powertrain is livened up a bit. The steering and handling of the EV9 works pretty well. It feels generally pretty planted. Going through turns, the steering is nice and responsive. There's a crispness to this car that really works and makes it feel a little bit smaller. Now, because this thing can get up to speed in a hurry, you've gotta really think ahead about the braking. This car does weigh 6,000 pounds. One of the ways to mitigate that is to play with the regenerative braking. So on the paddles, on the steering wheel back here, you can adjust it to more regen pressure by clicking the left paddle, or less down to a coast by clicking the right paddle. There's several different levels to play with here and they all make a very noticeable difference. So if you're in level zero, like we're in right now, you can come off the accelerator and the car will just naturally coast. And if you go all the way up to the strongest, I pedal max, and you start to go down a hill and come off the accelerator, it's bringing us down to a stop in a hurry. In fact, it's bringing us down to a full stop, which means the EV9 has one pedal driving, which a lot of EV owners really like because it's like a distinct feel that electric cars have that you don't get in a, you know, gasoline internal combustion car. Let's put it in sport one more time just for funsies and step on it. You know, a lot of EVs, even when you put them in sport and then really gun it, it'll still kind of give you a neutered version of the power, and that definitely felt like pretty close to full capacity power. If you're looking into EV9 and you're not sure whether to get one of the lower level models or this GT line, and power matters to you, I'd say give it a try. That is quick. Phew! There is a lot to know about the 2024 Kia EV9. So let's break it down by going over some of the pros and cons. Let's start with the good. First, I really like the focus on comfort and practicality, things that are really going to make a difference in people's everyday lives. I also like the different levels of pricing that are available to buyers and how value is packed into base models with standard features. And finally, I like that Kia went the extra mile with some of these EV features like vehicle to load and the 800 volt architecture. It shows that they didn't just put out an EV, they tried to make the most of the electric system. As for cons, you could say that the EV9 is a little bit middle of the road. And if you're an EV buyer looking to make a splash, you may have to look elsewhere. Second, a lot of the features that we showed you today are GT line exclusive. So just beware that base models are not gonna have so many gadgets. And finally, while future versions of the EV9 may qualify for the full tax credit, this one is not going to, at least not for the next year or so. To some people, that makes a big difference. All in all, this is a practical three-row family SUV that definitely isn't boring. That's all for today. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please click like and subscribe so you can see more just like it. And if you want to learn more about the Kia EV9 or any of its competitors, click the link in the description below. Until next time, thanks for watching.